The world is shaking.
The newest terrorist organization known as ISIS is overtaking Al-Qaeda's reign as public enemy number one.
From beheadings to forced amputations, it's one of the most extreme groups in the region. Too extreme even for Al-Qaeda.
Wars continue to break out between nations. Threats to annihilate millions of people from the face of the earth. Civil war, global terrorism, kidnappings and murder by extremists have escalated.
Iraq's largest Christian city now seized by ISIS militants. Tens of thousands of Christians are now fleeing for their lives.
Nation shall rise up against nation, kingdom against kingdom, famine, pestilences, earthquakes.
Disease, fears of a new devastating plague, and financial instability has intensified. What does it all mean? The answer will finally be revealed in this special presentation hosted by international speaker and author Morris Cerullo. For over 68 years, Morris Cerullo has traveled to the nations of the world, speaking before tens of millions of people, teaching about personal and spiritual transformation, biblical prophecy, international politics, and war. In this Morris Cerullo primetime special, you'll see how his powerful prophetic message of warning, preparation, and hope has now become more relevant today for every living person here on earth. This truly is a breakthrough revelation for our time. Here's Morris Cerullo with the single greatest sign of the return of Jesus.
They want to talk to us about the second coming and this breakthrough in prophecy and why I believe Jesus Christ is coming in our day. Matthew 24:3. And as he sat upon the Mount of Olives, the disciples came to Jesus privately and said to him, they asked him two questions. Tell us, when shall these things be? What shall be the sign of thy coming and of the end of the world? Two things, the sign of thy coming and of the end of the world. We've heard about the signs of wars. We've read them in every prophecy book that's ever been written. The signs of earthquakes, the signs of pestilences. Now, I believe that these are signs, but we have had wars for thousands of years. We've had earthquakes and pestilences for thousands of years. We had them since the time of Christ, and we had them before the time of Christ. Now, there are two things about these signs which I want us to come into an understanding about tonight. One is, in the last days, the signs of war and distresses that are coming upon the nations are coming with intensity. Nation shall rise up against nation, kingdom against kingdom, famines, pestilences, earthquakes. Look at the 8th verse. What does Jesus say? These are the beginning of sorrows. Then why are we going around printing so many books telling the world that the end is here? The end is not yet. These are the beginning of sorrows. but now he'll tell us when the end is. Two things. 14th verse. And this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world for a witness unto all nations, and then shall the end come. 2,000 years ago, this church was born, and it was born in a manifestation and in a demonstration. It wasn't born by oratory. It wasn't born by the organizational structure of denominations. It wasn't born by doctrine or by theology. 2,000 years ago, the Church of Jesus Christ was born. It was born in a demonstration. It was born in a manifestation through a church that was able to walk the streets, go through the cities, take down the works of the enemy, and manifest that Jesus Christ is who he claims to be, the Son of the living God. Do you know what the witness of the gospel is? The witness of the gospel is this, that Jesus Christ is alive, that the grave could not hold him, death could not bind him, Satan could not chain him, and this gospel shall be preached as a witness that in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God, and all things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. And he died on that cross. He shed his blood. He went into the grave, but he's alive. He's alive. The witness, the witness, the witness shall be preached in all the world for a sign.
Wars continue to break out between nations. Threats to annihilate millions of people from the face of the earth. Civil war, global terrorism, kidnappings and murder by extremists have escalated. Fighter jets and armed predator drones strike targets controlled by the Islamic militants. Monsoon rains provoke landslides. Tsunamis trigger killer floods and earthquakes, destroying nuclear plants where radioactive material is released on the heels of the catastrophic Chernobyl disaster.
Nation shall rise up against nation, kingdom against kingdom, famines, pestilences, earthquakes.
Disease, fears of a new devastating plague, and financial instability has intensified. What does it all mean? For over 68 years, Maurice Cerullo has traveled to the nations of the world, speaking before tens of millions of people, teaching about personal and spiritual transformation, biblical prophecy, international politics, and war. In this Maurice Cerullo Primetime Special, you'll see how his powerful prophetic message of warning, preparation, and hope has now become more relevant today for every living person here on Earth.
But the end is not yet.
Oh, hallelujah! Hallelujah! Come on, stand and give him a clap off! Let's go down to the 32nd verse. Jesus, remember, is speaking. Now learn a parable of the fig tree. When his branch is yet tender and putteth forth leaves, know that summer is nigh. You see, back here in Thessalonians, Paul said in First Thessalonians, the 5th chapter, the 1st verse, but of the times and the seasons, brethren, ye have no need that I write unto you. See, I'm not standing up here and telling you that we can know the day. Nobody knows the day when Jesus is coming. I cannot tell you the hour. I cannot tell you the month. I cannot tell you the year. But my brother, my sister, I can tell you the season. You know what harvest means, brother? You're gonna gather it in. You're gonna gather it in. Jesus says to us here, learn a parable of the fig tree. When his branch is yet tender and putteth forth leaves, know that summer is nigh at hand. So likewise you, when you see these things, know that it is near, even at the doors. What are you supposed to know? What is near? My coming. You've asked me, what is my coming? When is it? I'm telling you now, when you see the budding of the fig tree, don't wonder, don't question, don't ask anything. Just know, absolutely know, that I am standing at the door and it's ready to be open, and I'm coming. Fig tree always speaks prophetically in the scriptures of the nation of Israel. Israel is God's fig tree. Jesus said, there's coming a time. There's coming an hour in history when I'll forgive the rebellion of my children, the Jews. Their leaves will shoot. Buds will begin to appear on their tree. And I will fulfill my prophecy which I have promised to them, and that is this. I will bring them back from the four corners of the earth where I have scattered them because of their rebellion, and I will bring them back, and I will plant them as an end time witness and testimony. I will plant them back in their own land. Ezekiel 36:24. God says, I will take you from among the heathen. I will gather you out of all the countries. And I will bring you into your own land. 37th chapter of Ezekiel. How many of you believe that God Almighty speaks to people? How many of you believe he speaks to prophets? How many of you believe he spoke to Abraham? Moses, Jacob, Elijah. He spoke to a prophet by the name of Ezekiel. Let's look at it quickly and watch the budding of the fig tree and watch the great fulfillment of this magnificent end time prophecy. The hand of the Lord, said Ezekiel, was upon me and carried me out in the spirit of the Lord and set me down in the midst of the valley, which was full of bones. Have you ever heard sermons on the valley of dry bones? Come on. Many times God speaks in prophetic terms that are figurative. He's drawing pictures of what will come. I can take you through the Bible and show you how that it was prophesied in the last days, how that there would be automobiles. I can take you in the Bible, show you prophetically how it was prophesied in the last days there'd be airplanes. Literally. But they were figurative pictures that describe our busy streets today, filled bumper to bumper with automobiles prophesied in the Word. But what we are reading here in Ezekiel, the 37th chapter now, is not figurative. There's another way that God speaks the prophetic word, and that is literal. Say literal.
Literal.
Say literally.
Literally.
Say it again.
Literally.
This was not a figurative picture that God was drawing. But this was an actual experience. He picked up Ezekiel and tore down the veil of the future. And he brought Ezekiel by the spirit world down through hundreds and hundreds of years into the future and planted him into a literal thing that was taking place. And he wrote what he saw, which was yet to literally come to pass. God put him in a valley of dry bones. Literal bones. And Ezekiel said, God caused me to pass by them round about. And behold, there were very many in the open valley, and they were very dry. Do you remember of course you do, because the world will never forget the Holocaust, where a maniac, a man by the name of Hitler, controlled by demon powers, vowed to exterminate the Jews and several other classes of people. And he took 6 million Jews and burn them in human incinerators. And they scraped out of those incinerators dry bones. And they took them outside the concentration camps of Auschwitz and many others. And what did the Germans do with them? They got bulldozers and they dug deep valleys and they buried the bones of those Jews in those valleys. see the valley of dead, dry Jewish bones. God said to Ezekiel, "Son of man, can these bones live?" You see, after the last world war, what did the world say? They said the Jewish nation is broken, didn't they? Come on, didn't they? They said the Jews will never rise up again. Hitler may not have killed them all, but the power of the Jew is finished. And God said to Ezekiel, "Can these bones live? Can my people, Israel, ever rise up again?" And Ezekiel said, "I don't know. You're the only one that knows." And God said, "All right, Ezekiel, prophesy to these bones and say, oh, dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. Thus saith the Lord God unto thee, I will cause breath to enter into you. I'll lay flesh upon you. I'll cover you with skin. I'll breathe in you, and you shall live, and the world shall know that I am the Lord." So I prophesied, said Ezekiel, and there was a noise, and there was a shaking, and the bones came together, and flesh came upon them, and the Lord said, "Prophesy unto the wind." The wind is a type of the Holy Spirit, which shows that this happened in the time when Jesus was gone, who said, "When I go away, I'll send you a comforter, which is the Holy Ghost." Prophesy unto the wind and say unto the wind, "Come from the four corners and breathe upon these that were slain, that they may live." So I prophesied as he commanded me, and breath came into them, and they lived, and they stood on their feet, a great and exceeding great and mighty army. God raised up the nation of the Jew. And he said unto me, "Son of man, these bones are the whole house of Israel." They say our bones are dry. They say our hope is lost. They say we are cut off. God said, "Behold, O my people, I will open your graves, and I'll cause you to come up out of your graves, and I'll bring you to the land of Israel." Can you see them, brother? Come on. When a little Jew by the name of David Ben-Gurion shook his fist in the face of the whole United Nations, who were going to sell Israel down the river, and demanded that Israel be given back the nation, that the Jews be given back the nation of Israel, and demanded statehood, even the Russians, unparalleled, didn't know why they did it, but they voted in the United Nations to give Israel back to the Jew. From the southern tips of Yemen. They didn't know anything. They couldn't read, they couldn't write. But something tugged at them in their spirit. They left all their possessions. They got on donkeys and horses and camels, and they came across the streaming deserts. They came from India. They They came from all parts of Africa. They came from Europe. They came from all over the world. They came on homemade boats. They came in homemade airplanes. They didn't know why they were coming, but something was happening. The four winds was blowing, and the Jews were marching like a mighty army back to their land. There's an anointing of the Holy Spirit in this building tonight. Listen to what Jesus said. Learn a parable. I need to talk to you about this miracle for hours tonight. But put it in your spirit. Learn a parable. God said, when you see my people go back to my land, when you see the desert blossoming like a rose, I wish every one of you could go to the nation of Israel and see the great transformation that has taken place in that nation. The best grapefruits, the best oranges, the best figs in the world grow on what was once desert land. You say, Brother Cerullo, why do you believe this is the end time breakthrough? He said, no, when you see this is happening, that summer is nigh. And likewise, when you see these things, know that it is near, even at the door. Listen to that 32nd verse, and I don't know whether you can take this tonight. I don't know where you are spiritually. Put it in your spirit. 34th verse. Verily I say unto you, this generation shall not pass till all these things be fulfilled. What generation, Brother Cerullo? Yes. Generation that witnesses the gospel being brought into all the world for a sign and for a witness. What generation? The generation that's alive when God brings back his people to their own land. He's coming back to this earth with his mighty armies. And Revelation 19, you and I will see it come to pass. He's coming. He's coming.
Morris Cerullo believes this life-changing message presents the single greatest key for you and your family to prepare without any doubt for the return of Jesus and how you can meet him in the heavens in all his glory. Morris Cerullo prayer partners are on the helpline now, ready to take your calls. If you have questions, are ready to accept Jesus as your Savior, or if you just need someone to pray with you for a most urgent need, then call now. It's time for you to prepare for the return of Jesus. There's a toll-free number on your screen. Call. Don't hesitate. If the phone line is busy, call back. When you call, the prayer partner will also offer you a gift, free of charge. It's Morris Cerullo's gift to you, a special gift that includes a booklet called God Has a Plan for Your Life. It's God's master plan to forgive you, to redeem you, and give you a way to become a child of God. Along with this book, Maurice Cerullo will send you the book and companion DVD that represents the full, uncut version of this most anointed, timely message entitled The Single Greatest Sign of the Return of Jesus. Just call. It's toll-free. These are ministry gifts just for you when you act now. Pick up the phone and call. Yes, you can have these resources sent directly to you to share with your family and friends if you like. Visit our website at greatestsign.com. That's greatestsign.com. Or you can always write and request your gifts at the address on the screen. Call the toll-free number now. Speak with one of our helpline prayer partners and walk with confidence, knowing that you are chosen to be with Jesus when he returns.
And beloved, it will not be long. Father, your Holy Spirit is in this building. There's much more that needs to be said tonight. And we lift up our hearts and we say, Lord Jesus, will you please come quickly? Will you please come quickly? Will you please come quickly? Would you lift up your heads for one moment? I want to pray a special prayer for you tonight. There's an anointing in this building. It's like warm liquid fire. God is right by the side of every man and every woman, every young person in this arena tonight. Will you please believe God's servant? Not one person in this arena got in here by accident tonight. While my heart is filled with great joy, because I'm expecting Jesus to come, you are looking at a man. I do not say this boastfully. Scores of my staff are in this building tonight. You're looking at a man who lives and breathes the fact that Jesus is coming. Now listen. My heart tonight is very sad. Because if Christ were to come tonight, I do not believe that the greatest majority of the people that go to church on Sunday morning in all of our churches, regardless of denominations, I do not expect to see them make the rapture. Now, I don't say that tonight to scare you. See, the true test of a prophet of God is that what he speaks will come to pass. I say that tonight to prepare you. See, people have the idea that all you have to do is say, Lord, Lord, and you're going to go up and you're ready. That's not what my Bible tells me. My Bible tells me that people receive an eternal salvation because they are obedient unto Christ. More than anything in this world, I want this prophecy night to be a night where not one man, not one woman, not one boy, not one girl walks out of this arena without knowing that you're ready. If the trump of God were to sound tonight, it is written that not everyone that cries, Lord, Lord, will go up when Jesus comes, but he that doeth the will of my Father which is in heaven. Will you do this tonight in the Holy Spirit? Will you let this platform be transformed into a great mirror? And will you look inside that mirror tonight and will you say to yourself, Bob, Mary, Catherine, Johnny, whose will am I doing? Jesus, being the master of the kingdom, gave us another parable in the very next chapter after this parable, this story that we've been studying tonight. He said, the kingdom of heaven is like a man that goes away on a far journey. He calls his servants, which are you and I, and he gives unto them talents. One he gave five, one he gave two, one he gave one. When the master came back, the man with five had five more. The master blessed him and sent him into the kingdom. The man with two had two more. The master blessed him and sent him into the kingdom. He came down to the man with the one talent. And the man with the one talent said, wait a minute, Lord, I've got to go dig up my talent and I'll come and bring it to you. And the master, Jesus, said, what do you mean you have to dig it up? He said, I was afraid. And I went and I hid my talent in the earth. Now listen to me. I love you tonight. I would not hurt one hair upon your head in this building tonight. God knows that. But this is the most horrifying scripture I have ever read in the Bible. You know what Jesus said? He said, take from that man even that which he hath. Give it to him that hath 10 talents. For unto everyone that hath, it shall be given. But from him that hath not, it shall be taken away even that which he hath. And cast ye the unprofitable servant into outer darkness, where there is weeping and wailing and gnashing of teeth. Do you understand? This man was cast out of the kingdom. Why? Because he was a drunkard? No. Because he was a harlot with the lust of the flesh? No. He was a man, as much a member of the kingdom as the man who had five talents and the man who had two. There was only one difference. He did nothing with which one was entrusted to him. Do you understand? It takes more than crying, Lord, Lord, to go up when Jesus comes. He that doeth the will of my Father. You can't have been entrusted with the gospel and sit and do nothing and think God is going to reward you.
Morris Cerullo believes this life-changing message presents the single greatest key for you and your family to prepare without any doubt for the return of Jesus and how you can meet him in the heavens in all his glory. Morris Cerullo prayer partners are on the helpline now, ready to take your calls. If you have questions, are ready to accept Jesus as your Savior, or if you just need someone to pray with you for a most urgent need, then call now. It's time for you to prepare for the return of Jesus. There's a toll-free number on your screen. Call. Don't hesitate. If the phone line is busy, call back. When you call, the prayer partner will also offer you a gift, free of charge. It's Morris Cerullo's gift to you, a special gift that includes a booklet called God Has a Plan for Your Life. It's God's master plan to forgive you, to redeem you, and give you a way to become a child of God. Along with this book, Morris Cerullo will send you the book and companion DVD that represents the full, uncut version of this most anointed, timely message entitled The Single Greatest Sign of the Return of Jesus. Just call. It's toll free. These are ministry gifts just for you when you act now. Pick up the phone and call. Yes, you can have these resources sent directly to you to share with your family and friends if you like. Visit our website at greatestsign.com. That's greatestsign.com. Or you can always write and request your gifts at the address on the screen. Call the toll-free number now. Speak with one of our helpline prayer partners and walk with confidence, knowing that you are chosen to be with Jesus when he returns.
Bow your heads. We're going to pray. Spirit of God, do the work of the Father tonight. God, you're going to have a peculiar people in this end time. You're going to have a people that's called by your name. You're going to have a people that are walking in righteousness as flames of fire in this last day. An anointing of the Holy Spirit of God to set your souls free. God, I'm not asking you for 50%. I'm asking you for 100% in this building. Of every man and every woman, every young person, I'm asking for a spiritual breakthrough. I'm asking you to break the chains of traditional Christianity that would hold your people from moving into the spiritual experience that they need tonight to enable them to say, I am ready if Jesus Christ were to come tonight. Very quickly, I'm going to pray for you. The only thing I'm going to ask you tonight, right now, in the name of Jesus, is this. I don't care what church you belong to, Catholic, Protestant, Jewish, Charismatic, Pentecostal, Baptist, Presbyterian, Episcopalian, Methodist. I'm not concerned. I'm only concerned with this one thing. If Jesus Christ were to come tonight, and he could, there's nothing that could hold him back. Are you ready to meet him? If you'll say to me tonight, Brother Cerullo, I am not sure that I am ready. And I want your prayers, because I'm going to pray right now, for God to grant you the greatest miracle in the world, the healing of your soul. That's the greatest miracle that God can give to you tonight. Heal your soul. You say to me tonight, Brother Cerullo, I'm not sure that I'm ready. But I want to be ready tonight when you pray that prayer for God to grant the greatest miracle in the world, the healing of men and women's souls. I want you to pray for me. I want God to heal my soul. I want God to forgive all of my sins, whether they're backslidden sins or whatever they are. I want God to forgive my sins. I want God to heal my soul. I want to walk out of this building tonight. I want to know that I am ready to meet Jesus. If you want my prayer that God may give you this miracle in your life tonight, that you may know that you're ready to meet Jesus, take this next step with me quickly, please, that God may give you this miracle in your soul right now. Stand on your feet and remain standing for the prayer. All right, let's come now together in the name of Jesus. Come. Don't hesitate in those chairs. That's a lie of the devil. He wants you to hesitate. He wants you to think it over. Faith is an act. This is God's night to heal your soul and to set it free. Soon as you get here, lift those hands up to God. Close your eyes. Forget Brother Cerullo. Forget I'm even here. Forget I'm even here. And stretch those hands out to him and say, God, forgive me. Heal my soul. Forgive my sins. I want to be ready to meet you. People, I have no control. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon you. I can see it like a cloud of glory all over your hands. Go ahead, put your hands up and talk to him. Put your hands up and talk to him. Yes, yes. Go ahead, ask him. God, forgive me. God, forgive me. God, forgive me. Heal my soul. 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 Jesus. I am so excited today to see these thousands of people coming forward, making the greatest decision of their life. Lord Jesus, I believe you are the Son of the living God. Thank you for giving your life to rescue me and to set my soul free. Why I'm so excited is because what God is doing for all of these that have come forward, he's reaching out through this television special and he's saying to you, I want you to experience the greatest miracle in the world. And all you have to do is like these did, simply open your heart and invite Jesus to become your Lord. I have a very special gift for you. I wrote this book especially for you that are experiencing Christ. God has a plan for your life. Doesn't that sound good? You're not just a number. You're not just someone. God knows you by your name, and he has a divine plan. I want to send this book to you. It's my gift for you tuning in and being a part of this primetime television special. the single greatest sign of the return of Jesus. Yes, Jesus is coming back. I have two gifts for you that are watching the telecast and being a part today. One, you know, it's not enough to just one time hear this message, but I want to send it to you on a special DVD, not only just of the message as you have seen it on the primetime special, but the complete message. There's even more to the message. I want to send it to you as a gift. And also, I have prepared the entire transcript of the single greatest sign of the return of Jesus in a manuscript form. I want to send all of these three things as a special gift to you. I love you. And remember this. You are a part of the plan of Almighty God. And did you know that God has not planned any defeats for you?
Morris Cerullo believes this life-changing message presents the single greatest key for you and your family to prepare without any doubt for the return of Jesus and how you can meet him in the heavens in all his glory. Morris Cerullo prayer partners are on the helpline now, ready to take your calls. If you have questions, are ready to accept Jesus as your Savior, or if you just need someone to pray with you for a most urgent need, then call now. It's time for you to prepare for the return of Jesus. There's a toll-free number on your screen. Call. Don't hesitate. If the phone line is busy, call back. When you call, the prayer partner will also offer you a gift, free of charge. It's Morris Cerullo's gift to you, a special gift that includes a booklet called God Has a Plan for Your Life. It's God's master plan to forgive you, to redeem you, and give you a way to become a child of God. Along with this book, Morris Cerullo will send you the book and companion DVD that represents the full, uncut version of this most anointed, timely message entitled The Single Greatest Sign of the Return of Jesus. Just call. It's toll free. These are ministry gifts just for you when you act now. Pick up the phone and call. Yes, you can have these resources sent directly to you to share with your family and friends if you like. Visit our website at greatestsign.com. That's greatestsign.com. Or you can always write and request your gifts at the address on the screen. Call the toll-free number now. Speak with one of our helpline prayer partners and walk with confidence, knowing that you are chosen to be with Jesus when he returns.
Before I leave you on this primetime special, I want to invite you to pick up your telephone. There's a number on the screen. Call it right now. In a few moments, I'm going to be praying. This is the prayer altar for the primetime television special. I'd like to have your need placed on this prayer altar. I want to believe, God, you're not watching this incredible single greatest sign of the return of Jesus message by accident. Look behind me. Here you see incredible prayer warriors. Each one of them know how to receive your prayer need personally right now, so that we can include them when we pray for any need.
that you have with God. All things are possible.
And before we go, Maurice Cerullo would like to invite you to attend his 44th annual World Conference in Nashville. It's time for the Holy Spirit to release a mighty, unprecedented wave of revelation and restoration upon you. This miracle will be made manifest when you attend Maurice and Teresa Cerullo's 44th annual World Conference in Nashville. This is your time to receive all that God has destined for you. This powerful, anointed conference will spiritually launch you into the new year, beginning Tuesday, January 6th through Saturday, January 10th, 2015, at the gorgeous Gaylord Opryland Resort and Convention Center.
God, I pray for the gift of discernment to fall upon your people. I pray for the gift of spiritual eyesight. Fall!
Joining Maurice Cerullo are such respected men of God and speakers as Perry Stone, Jensen Franklin, Joseph Walker, Steve Muncy.
I'm talking about God coming directly into your life and delivering you from things that will blow your mind.
Iowa Ritza Jafor, Pastor Bill Winston, and more. Plus, this year, you will be blessed with Maurice Cerullo's special guest, former Arkansas governor and U.S. presidential candidate, Mike Huckabee, who currently hosts his own weekly program on the Fox News Channel. You're invited, so get excited and register today. Call the number on the screen or visit our website. Registration for non-locals is $125. Receive free full breakfast, conference materials, and get a room rate of only $52. As always, there will be amazing, award-winning singers, musicians, and dynamic praise and worship teams. Just announced, award-winning gospel concert pianist, Huntley Brown. There are plenty of reasons to attend this 44th annual World Conference in Nashville. But get ready, at this conference, Maurice Cerullo will lead an historic worldwide prayer assembly, a 24-hour period of intense intercession and spiritual breakthrough prayer. Together, we will pray and intercede as never before. Bring your most urgent and personal needs to the conference and let the mighty prayer generals from around the world pray for you. Make your reservation now. Plan to attend the Maurice and Teresa Cerullo 44th Annual World Conference in Nashville, beginning Tuesday, January 6th through Saturday, January 10th at the Gaylord Opryland Resort and Convention Center.